When I told my gorgeous wife, Alyssa, that I'd be speaking at Aaron and Mickey's wedding, she reminded me that I still haven't sent them a thank you note from our wedding, which was 16 months ago. So here's the thank you note, backdated to November 2012, okay? See, thank you right there. Dear Mickey and Aaron, thank you so much for the extremely generous gift. We hope to use it towards the purchase of a home in a less than desirable and barely affordable area in the near future. Alyssa and I were so glad we could share our sympathy with you both. Mickey, I truly hope you are planning to man up and pop the question soon, because we both think Aaron is a great catch. She is beautiful, kind, smart, entrepreneurial, and ambitious. And you should really lock her down. Aaron, I think you should know some things about Mickey before you take your relationship to the next level. We have grown up together, and for many years, it looked like we would grow old together too. Mickey and I first met 26 years ago in grade one at USDS. I was the redheaded kid who just moved to the neighborhood, and Mickey was the new Romanian exchange student. Mickey was a rather husky child. When he was 9 years old, he quit North Toronto baseball because he couldn't do up his pants. Mickey went through puberty virtually overnight. In 1995, he came home from Camp Northland with a deep voice, the world's thickest leg hair, and a bad teenage mustache.
He still has it!
All three have stood the test of time. These days, Mickey will shave his mustache twice a day if he has a late afternoon or evening meeting, but he only shaves the rest of his face once every 3 days, whether he needs to or not. In 1995, October to be exact, Mickey celebrated his bar mitzvah with family and friends. He holds the record for wearing his bar mitzvah suit all through high school, into university, until the age of 21. In grade 8, Mickey made the Forest Hills Select hockey team, which led to the birth of his alter ego, Hockey Mickey. Hockey Mickey is an insufferable goon. He accumulated more penalty minutes, more game misconducts, and more suspensions than any player in league history. His reputation for nastiness on the ice is the stuff of legend. Despite his belligerence, Hockey Mickey was a highly effective shutdown defenseman with offensive upside and a heavy shot. His skills have eroded considerably with age, and he is now a sluggish forward who won't play D and has a decent saucer pass. He works on it. In grade 10, before Mickey had his driver's license, he decided to steal his mom's royal blue Ford Taurus and go for a spin. So where would Mickey go when he was driving his mom's car, underage, without a license, and praying not to get busted? Well, obviously, he drove right past Mark Cooper's house, right at the same moment that Mark and his father were walking out the front door. Mickey sensed our presence as he headed south down Chiltern Hill, so he made certain not to turn his head, hoping we wouldn't notice. I noticed, and I was shocked. My dad noticed too. His reaction was more confusion than anything, and he said, "Geez, you know, I never realized how much Claudia looks like Mickey." He almost got away with it, but Mickey, in his infinite wisdom, went around the block and made another pass. By this time, my dad and I had gotten into our car, and we pulled up to the same intersection, perpendicular to one another. And Mickey, courteous underage driver that he was, waved us all through. My dad looked at me, smiled coyly, and never said a word. So Aaron, all this having been said, I do think Mickey is excellent husband material. He can be stubborn at times, but he is honest to a fault, loyal like a soldier, and has the thighs of a Romanian powerlifter. And given your career in the fashion industry, Mickey is a truly perfect match. He wears white jeans and cardigans and sports scarves all year round, both outdoors and in. Mickey also bears a striking resemblance to most brown-haired individuals with big square glasses and minimal necks. Most notably, Horatio Sands of Saturday Night Live and country singer Katie Lang. You'll probably find yourself going to 3 or even 4 functions some nights, as Mickey has far too many friends and a tendency to overbook. He always tries to stop by. Unless, of course, he forgot his suit jacket at the office, in which case he'll have to go back and get it. I love you both, and you should really tie the knot soon. It would bring me much, much nothing. How about a destination wedding? Lots of love, Mark and Alyssa. P.S. Thank you for the generous gift.